discretion is advised.
Happy Monday. You are listening and or watching PWNCAST. This is episode 117. We are in the final day of patch 6.2.4 as of Tuesday the 19th. It will no longer be that patch, and we will be in Legion's pre-patch. Tonight, we have a lot to talk about. There's a lot on the agenda. We're going to be talking about the World Quest Q&A, PvP talk, all things pre-patch to help you guys make sure you make the most out of your evening for those of you watching live, and much, much more. So make sure you guys stay right here.
In the World of Warcraft trade chat, troll-based offenses are considered especially heinous. In Azeroth, the dedicated players who call out these asshats are members of the elite squad known as the PWNCAST Podcast. These are their story.
Welcome back. I'm not really sure if I want to unmute these guys. I kind of feel like we could just have an intimate moment. It's just you and I. We could just say all the things we've always wanted to say and give our confessions. Just kidding. Now's not the time. Let me unmute these guys.
There was a Vaporeon right in front of us.
And don't I even. Actually... I will remove you from this call right now. Want to see Belle rage? Start talking about shit you're not supposed to be talking about during the show.
Did you hear about the new sniper healer they have?
So I'm going to go ahead and continue to mute those guys. So I did bring the Riders of Rohan with me. They are muted because they're talking about things that are not, they're not supposed to be talking about. So, but I did bring the DK who, the DK who only chose to be, to be a Worgen so that he could cover his bald spot. But get it? Worgen, Rogaine. Get it?
Okay, that's all right.
And that is one. Look at that thing.
Ooh, that's a clean shave on that. Looking
I'm
good.
So amused by that intro. That was Aja's touch right there, guys. I can't
that
take
looks
credit
good.
For that.
He looks straight out of fucking
get
Vikings.
It? Wargame. Get it? Get it?
No.
That's sad.
Yeah, we got it now. I wouldn't have got it, actually, if you didn't say it.
I did also bring the shaman who got in trouble with the labor force for using gnomes to power his totems. Huge bloke.
I wish I had some gnomes.
That'd be actually pretty cool.
Moving house sucks. Having no internet and then having to come to your parents' place is worse.
I gotta move you down a bit because you're like your box dude. Yeah, that might be a little bit better. Sorry guys, I'm just adjusting his box.
It's alright, I'll turtle box.
That's
how you know you're good friends. You can just move around his box at a whim. I did also bring the monk who was arrested when his rolling caused a dizzying haze in public. Jimma Banks.
Jimma Banks. It only happened one time. One time I learned
Aja's
my lesson.
Aja's creative genius at work, man.
He doesn't like to repeat that mistake.
I mean, I heard there was a time where that did happen. I did also bring the priest who gave the gift of the moose this weekend. Secret sauce.
Yes, I did. And that was specifically for one person for a Sunday run. And it worked out where we got like 7 people there, Moose. We had to have a few people leave. DPS was there, but we'll do another one hopefully maybe this Sunday. Maybe. That's what I'm going to shoot for, to try to get as many people as their Moose as possible. So, yeah.
How many people got theirs tonight? That night?
Seven. 6 or 7. Mm.
Yeah, is it moose or like mice or is, what do you call a collective of the mooses?
Mooses?
I too moose wonder eye? That same thing.
I thought it was just, like goose, there was geese, a... moose, geese.
Is it mooses?
Mm. No, it's meese, like geese.
No, it's
like
just a herd of moose.
Geese, so it's meese. It's school of mooses are meese.
Who is the person responsible for naming these animals? And I always thought, like, if you have multiple penis, is it peni? Is that, like, am I the only one that's ever wondered what, like, a collective of them would be? Like, if you just had, like, a collection.
Did you just take this to, like, a hentai channel?
But, like, am I the only one that's, would it be peni? Can somebody help me? Is that?
I don't have multiple
penises. Ask Remedies. He's probably the best one to.
So is that, like, a few? The drenai as a race, does that mean an individual one is a drenus?
We can just do this for days, guys. Okay, but if you're... I understand that it would be... Obviously, it would be dicks. But, I mean, I'm just wondering, like, if there was multiple, would it be peni? Because that's what I refer to them as. Like, if there's, like, a ton of them, like, just...
Penises.
Around in, just like, a collection. Just
hanging out in the lounge room.
We have Warcraft news to talk about.
I would have to say that Murky's the expert on us, and he said it is penises.
Penicorn, for real. He right. really knows. So... Pre-patch, so obviously, bad. Is going to be on the 19th. I don't know what this means for EU because I don't live in the EU, but I know it's not the 19th, right? It's the 20th for them. Not really sure how that works. But regardless, pre-patch is coming when the normal, you know, when they do all the server maintenance. So the normal day stuff gets updated is going to be when that happens, which it's Wednesday for EU, right? Is that?
Yes.
Sure.
No, okay. Not that I'm in the EU, but it's tonight for us.
Right. Wait, what?
Well, you're in the EU.
So EU's before?
I was waiting.
I don't even know, guys. I don't even know. I just know it's a different time. Somebody always makes sure I get corrected. I don't live in the EU, so when I say when the pre-patch hits, I'm telling you what time in the USA it hits, and it's going to be the 19th. Now, the servers are going to be shut off about 7 or 5 PST, and then they're supposed to be back on at 11 a.m., but we all know that that's not really going to be the case. We're probably
looking
at about
5.
I mean, last time they did a huge pre-patch, it was on by 1 o'clock. So I think it just depends on how all the things go. Hopefully they've got all their ducks in the row and they've done all the things that they needed to do. But if you're going to take the day off, go have breakfast and brunch and go do laundry and go do stuff and then stop. Please, please don't complain at 11.
We'll just go to bed and wake up and it will be there like we Icelandic people do.
I didn't take any time off for the patch. I did take 8 days off for the expansion launch because reasons. But, yeah, so make sure. Some of the things that you need to be aware of with pre-patch, the new class changes are going to be in effect. So this gives you a little bit of time before Legion to get to know your class all over again, get to know some of the changes that happened, the glyphs being removed, the new talents, the way that they're organized, that whole thing is in play. If you are not sure what your class looks like because you don't have beta access and you're curious, you can look at the PTR or you can go to the PWNCAST YouTube channel and see all that stuff. But you'll get to see it tomorrow, so it's not that big of a deal. Wardrobe and appearance changes, that's also going to be in play. You'll have your new appearance tab. Something important to note. You don't want to vendor your items tonight. You want to make sure you wait tomorrow. Before you start going vendor happy after patches live tomorrow, I would suggest that you look in your appearance tab and make sure that you see some of the items that you have in your bag and bank just to make sure. Sometimes when stuff happens in development and coding, stuff goes wrong. So just make sure that you check to see if you have that before you actually go crazy vendoring. And then once you see that your appearance tab has picked it up, then you can go ahead and go ham. Some of you
Did it work for the tabards? Yes, right?
Yeah. And the cool thing is, so in your mount, pet, and heirloom tab is going to be where your appearance tab is. So keep in mind that with this appearance tab change, which we did a nice video on it, if you get confused, it's on the YouTube channel, you'll be able to set outfits so that you can quickly transmog them, which is really, really nice if you have, like, say, a daytime outfit, or you have a nighttime outfit, or you have a raid outfit. Or you have somebody playing the drums. What's happening, guys? What is that?
A pet battle outfit?
What is that noise? Somebody?
Look at you tweaking hard on the noises.
Because I can hear it and I can't talk when I can hear the pounding of a drum, maybe.
Did you, like, snort ribble or something before the show?
No, but I hear what you guys don't, so I could hear, like, a tapping.
Stop with the noises. Stop. Stop with the noises.
They're all in my head.
These guys have been irritating me for about 17 minutes now, so...
Fuck that. I was eating dinner.
Exactly. I've only been online for 13 and a half.
So I
told my mother, Belle, what you said.
I love your mother. So make sure with your appearance tab, you remember that you can transmog off your shoulders. You can transmog off your helmet. You won't do that in the settings anymore. You'll do that from the appearance, or, you know, you'll do that from the transmog window. So you have to either pick up get your transmog mount or go to a transmog vendor. Then you can hide your helmet and you can hide your shoulders as well. So make sure that you guys note that so that you guys can make the changes. I'm happy about that because there's a lot of shoulders that look really derpy with some of the stuff I have. So
do you know if the transmog thing, and this might be just a fair warning, check your void storage too if you're worried about gear that's missing. I don't know if the transmog system will be 100% where it's going
to
pull it out.
Supposed
but I've
to.
Got shit.
It says it
a
is.
A lot of void storage, though.
Yeah, it's supposed to. So. Anything that you have on your person that you've collected, the appearance tab is supposed to pick up, which is why I said just always check to make sure that you're, especially items that were a little bit harder to acquire, just make sure you have them before you guys go ham and then set up your outfits. You can name your outfits, different things, and then when you go to the transmog vendor, you can just pick the outfit that you want and just be done. The
stupidest thing I've ever. You can have Slutmog or Slutiermog.
Okay, like, first
I was
of
thinking
all,
the same thing.
But... I have like different attire for different things, so it's nice that you can have like my PvP transmog. I would like to be different than my random just walking about. And then if I have like say a date in game, I might want to, you know, have something. Something new.
Have a throwback to the side boot transmog of a couple months back.
You know, yeah. In the fucking inn.
He doesn't even game anymore. I don't even know.
I know he doesn't.
I know what he's doing.
We pay for his sub, and then he's not even doing that. We pay for his sub, and he just sits in there and watches Netflix. So that's pretty much the way that works out. He just gave me a
dirty look. That's not all he's doing.
And he flipped me off.
Not all he's doing.
He flipped me off.
That's accurate.
He hasn't even been doing that lately.
I can't wait to see how much bag space I get back. Like, I literally have guild banks of seven or eight tabs full of gear just sitting there waiting. I'm like, vendor it all, and then sell the guild.
Is the toy thing taken over too, the new toy system?
Yes.
Because there's a lot of your items, too, that are engineering are now toys.
No, they haven't said anything specifically about the toy system in the pre-patch, so I don't know 100%. I will find that answer out after show. If I'm sure Remedy is on and he'll correct me as he always does.
He's already looking right now. Yeah. So
I didn't see it referenced specifically, but I didn't. The Demon Invasion is next on the list for what's going to be happening. Once I don't know if it's going to be right at pre-patch launch, but the Demon Invasions will pop up randomly in the cities, the zones that they chose for that. And you'll be able to go and do that. Now, it's important to note that there's going to be several things leading to Legion. So when you guys complete the Demon Invasion and there's going to be the whispers around your capital city that allow you to turn into this thing and you do some weird shit and some other weird shit that I never really fully grasped the concept on just because it wasn't really that interesting to me. But it's not just going to be the one thing. There's several things that are going to be leading up to Legion. So for those of you that are wondering, you know, should I sub for pre-patch? If you want to take advantage and do the quests that are going to be happening, the Demon Invasion and all that kind of thing, then you probably want to log in and do it. Since they're doing the pre-patch so soon, meaning it's a little bit more than a month that they're doing this pre-patch, I'm assuming they're going to give us... Yeah, I'm assuming they're going to give us plenty to do so that we're not bored waiting. But in the meantime, you can learn your class because, I mean... A lot of changes.
Yeah.
There's always going to be those people, though, because I know tomorrow I'll jerry-rig my internet back together and just be like, bang, 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 do it across all my characters, and they'll be like, okay, now what do I do for the next 4 weeks? But there's other people that don't have the luxury of that time, so it's going to drag out. But
for sure.
I could almost guarantee that within the next, say, 3 to 4 days, they'll be like, oh my god, it was too shit, it was too short, come on, what else you got, this is boring, well, I was fucked, I'm gonna re-cancel again.
I'm looking to see anything about the toys.
I figured, like, in Warlords, I mean, they dropped the, what was it, the Iron Starlet and the Bronze Whelpling. So I'm assuming that they're going to drop more pets this time around as well.
Well, and it was really lame, though. Like, the one for when we did the Shattered... What is it? The Shattered Beach? It was, like, 5 minutes and that whole quest line was over.
The most disappointing pre-launch event I've ever seen ever in the history of Everness.
I would like pre-launch to, like, last at least a week. Like, something. At least...
Also, the PvP is done. So as of in the morning, you're done with PvP until what I'm assuming is probably going to be 4 or 5 weeks after Legion launches. Because usually,
I'm never done with PvP on PvP server.
Yeah, usually after it's usually a few weeks after the expansion launches before they announce the season. But this time around, we're going to be having shorter seasons. So we had, what did we have, 3 or 4 seasons in Warlord? So I'm assuming that's going to be doubled, which is nice. The shorter seasons is important, too, because it gives you something to work towards quickly, and then you move on, you start over, and you get to work towards more. Because there's going to be so many rewards in the situation with prestiging, you only get 4 prestige levels at launch. So your very first season, you're only going to be able to prestige 4 times, and they're going to be adding that every season. So
what's the cap, then?
There isn't one at this moment.
Infinity.
Because, yeah,
I know, right?
I think this is going to be an ongoing thing that they're going to just keep working towards. And then I'm assuming later they'll be adding that. But we're actually going to be talking about the PvP changes in depth for Bell's Byte segment. Since I did do a PvP video about it, I wanted to address the PvPers. I know, I'm just an overachiever.
Yes. Yeah, since you were unavailable all weekend type shit.
I
did confirm, as for the patch notes, by the way, a number of items with novel effects will be converted into for inclusion in the toy box.
Why couldn't they just say toy updates? Why do they have to be so complicated so you have to search through stuff? Ugh.
And there's a new toy. It's called the soft foam sword that you can actually smack somebody.
It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, and take them down to lower health without killing them. It's awesome.
So obviously we already
So we can have sword fights?
We already know that they're nerfing the past raids, right? So those of you that farmed, get in there one last night and get it done, get some extra gold because they are nerfing
that. Did you read that they're gonna nerf the Kata raids, but they're gonna rebuff the Lich King raids? Like that, I didn't get that. Like I would have figured
difficulty
that
wise.
I think what they're trying to do is normalize the gold output for the raids. Kata raids would give you. I mean, I would make close to 2,000 gold on a clear of Firelands. It would only take me a half hour, 45 minutes. Where I would go into the Lich King raid and go to clear that real quick, and it would only give me like 700 gold, 600 gold. So I think what they're trying to do is normalize all the old content so that there is still a chance for you to go out there and farm the old gold, but not were to a point where you can actually just make a living off it. Because at a point there, I was actually making enough on Kata Rage to pay for myself every month.
Right.
And also, I think that's... Also, the legendary quest line, no more as of tomorrow. So if you haven't been in there and done and did the things and gotten and seen and acquired,
Tomorrow's the last day to start it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, it's no longer available. So, if you have if you're currently in progression for your ring on alts, you have until the launch of Legion to complete that out. To be perfectly honest, though, I replaced my ring within like the first 20 quests that I did in Legion. So if you don't have it,
serious?
Yeah.
Is it maxed out?
Yeah. If you don't have it, don't freak out. It's gonna be fine. You're gonna get like an 8. I think like I want to say like 810 was the first high item level thing I got in like 20 quests. The gear, it's the same. Like it was the same with the cape, though. How many quests before that cape was bullshit? You didn't even need it anymore.
That's always been the case with every expansion. Yeah. Like everyone's like, "Yeah, let's gear up before the end of the expansion." And I think it was actually Hots that sort of said it perfectly. It's like the whole concept of gearing up as best you can before an expansion drops is just going to give you that little added advantage to take you a bit further through the questing before you actually have to replace your gear. It's going to happen regardless. Like there's no question about it. It's just a matter of when, be it the first few questions.
I haven't replaced my gear until 97.
To be honest,
I've never heard anyone say they're going to gear up before an expansion.
A lot of people say it because that's their line of thinking. They think the higher their item level, the easier it's going to be for them to quest, which is a valid thought process, right? However, you guys get this gear so quickly and you're doing your questing because you're doing multiple things. You're doing quests for your class order haul. You're doing, that doesn't matter once you get 110 and you do all that, then you get world quests. But it's always been the case, like people rush to do it at the end of an expansion. Really, the gearing should be done at the beginning of an expansion so you can enjoy it throughout the whole expansion, right? Definitely not at the end. But if you're one of those people that's freaking out, it's going to be okay. It's not going to be too serious if you don't have a legendary ring. You're going to replace it, so it's not make or break anything you do in Legion outside of maybe allowing you to take a hit more from a boss or.
And I'm sure there'll be another legendary somewhere down there, or something that's going to.
Well, there's several legendaries.
Yeah, there's a ton of them
sprinkled throughout that.
But
there'll be something along the same lines that's just going to take years to farm.
Yeah,
or it feels like it.
Well, even with, like, I know through my leveling experience through the beta, some of my 720, 725 gear that I had was replaced by, I had actually got a 705 green ring off a quest that was better stats than this 720 ring that I, or 720 gear that I had. So you're going to be replacing it even with the green stuff that's going to have far more better stats, may even have a lower item level, so don't freak out.
It was the same thing in Draenor, though. We replaced a lot of your shiny purples with ugly greens, but the stats are better.
And it's always heartbreaking, especially for raiders as well. Like, it's always heartbreaking that gear that you busted your ass for all the expansion long, and then you get, like, 15 quests in, and you're like, oh, yeah, I just replaced it with a green for killing 20 boars.
Your Brawler's Guild also is going away, and the Stranglethorn Fishing Extravaganza is being taken out. Now, let me tell you what I think now. So we know that the Brawler's Guild's getting a revamp, but something the gentleman said, I think his name was Jason, I don't remember which developer it was. So during the last Q&A for the World Quest, he talked about the Stranglethorn Fishing Extravaganza coming back as a World Quest. I'm wondering if the Brawler's Guild's going to be tied to that. The only reason I was thinking is because they're both taking a break, and I knew they were revamping, but I have a feeling because they want these world quests, which we're going to talk about that in a few minutes. They want the world quest to tap each area of Warcraft, right? They want it to touch on each individual area, pet battles, group things with killing world bosses. Like they have it touching on a variety of different things. So I wonder if, since the fishing extravaganza is going to come back as a world quest, I wonder how that's gonna work out. I'm hoping maybe they'll do some things for Brawler's Guild. The only reason being is I feel like they did a good thing there because it's really stale, right? What do you really have to work towards in the Brawler's Guild? Because there's nothing new that's added to it. So hopefully they're revamping that to make that better. But you won't be able to do that. So if there's stuff you want to do, you better get in there and do it now. The tap changes, all creatures and NPCs can now be tapped by up to 5 other characters. I know we talked about that a few episodes ago about them trying to make it easier for people to kill mobs and NPCs. That also is going into effect. And then we talked about the talent system, the glyph system. Now keep in mind, the glyphs will still be there, but they're going to be minor glyphs only. So typically they're going to be cosmetic changes. If you're a warlock and you use the glyph of nightmares, it's super important that you go get your freaking water mounts, your, what is that thing called?
Water strider.
The water strider, because there's no Glyph of Nightmares in beta as of now. I've been checking every single beta build, praying that the gods remember to put that in there. But as of now, if you're a warlock and you're fucking used to
lazy
that,
ass.
You don't have that. What is lazy about having a water walking mount? How does that equal lazy at all?
Because you're the only one that has it.
Because I'm a warlock.
I don't give a shit. Teleport over there.
Path of ice.
You're a priest. Do you not use levitate for things?
No.
Okay, fuck off. Yes, you do. You're a liar. All priests use really the levitate. You're such a liar.
I only use it when I fucking get shot in the air. That's the only time I
ever. Gnome hunters. Gnomes can be hunters, which we already knew that, but that's going to be...
They're going to be everywhere. I don't know why they weren't hunters before, though.
Draenor perks are going to be removed. I'm super sad about that, but it was going to happen anyway, so I guess it gives me time to kind of just get used to the things. And then hunters and shamans can now equip mail armor from level 1, which it used to be you had to be level 40 before you're...
I didn't know that. That's...
Yeah.
And which is pretty warriors cool. And DKs and paladins can level
can
or have...
Yep.
Can learn to have plate from 1? Good.
Yep. They can... Yep. And then the... this is something we all talk about all the time because everybody's obsessed with the human racial. Okay, all you crybabies out there who QQ'd about the human racial, you all won. You beat the game. You can all go
How
home
How about
now.
QQing? It's a proven fact. Everyone plays Alliance. And didn't I say that a couple? You guys
but
said
you
I was
say
all...
that as a blanket statement. I don't play Alliance and a human because of the racial. No. I never did.
What do you
I
mean,
did.
Blanket statement? I'm There's saying
a blanket statement though.
It's a known. I don't even know what that means.
my hunter.
Aww. I love blankets.
But people,
I'm saying it's a fact. People are Alliance for PvP, and
some
I said that about
yes, some people.
I said that 3 months ago, and you guys were making fun of me. I'm like, they should look at it where everyone has something like that. And you can look at the racials, and you guys are all like, what are you smoking? And
we
I'm
were
like,
just making fun of you. They've been talking about this racial change for a year and a half. So
I've actually changed
We're totally
my hunter.
Just making fun of you.
I rage changed my hunter to human just for the PvP benefit. So I am one of them.
I'm sure there are people that do it, but like everybody always tells me, oh, you're just a hunter, or you're just a human because of the racial. I didn't even know the racial was important until last expansion. So there's that. But
I was an Oak Warrior and missed for their racial.
The change isn't too terrible. We still get to keep it. It just is for stuns only, which is fair. I'm not saying that's not
more balanced.
I mean, it didn't affect me one way or the other. I'm not one of the people that's crying because it got changed. There's a lot of people that are upset about it. I personally don't care one way or the other because I'm pretty happy with the PvP talents that we're going to be getting. So it kind of makes me just not care about the one talent.
You talk about those people too much.
No, but it's like, it's not that big of a deal one way or the
That's
other.
What I'm saying.
The fact is, it's being changed.
Called balancing, yeah, which everyone's like, crying about a balance. You want balance.
Yeah, but it's never going to be balanced.
No, of course, but their attempt. Nate. When you guys say it's never like going to be balanced, they're sitting there attempting to balance
but
everything.
But even Holinka said PvP's never going to be balanced.
It can't be because of course not, but their goal is to balance it as much as possible, but it's impossible because you have X amount of classes and specs.
You're right.
But their goal is to balance it as much as possible. Better.
So now this just means there's going to be a ton of orcs running around in PvP, which is totally fine because the orc racial is pretty awesome. So that's it's whatever. I personally
it was even better before.
Yeah, I personally don't care one way or the other.
More of them for me to kill.
I still get to keep it for stuns, which is equally as important.
Yes.
To me, that's equally as important to be able to have that. So not too big of a deal. But removes all stun effects, and it does share a 30-second cooldown with other items of that ability, which isn't, that's not a huge deal either. You shouldn't be able to have, you know, multiple get-out-of-shit cards.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree with that completely. The human spirit has been redesigned. Human characters now gain 1% more of all secondary stats, haste, critical strike, mastery, and versatility from all sources. So those were the racial abilities to note in the for the pre-patch. And then, of course, as you guys know, all the missions from your garrison
are getting nerfed.
They're getting nerfed. So that also happens. So make sure you guys... and newly obtained salvage from the crate yard no longer contain equipable items. Salvage obtained from before the patch remains unaffected. So that's pretty cool.
Well, there goes 400 that I have just sitting there. Yes.
Yeah.
You do have time to open them up.
Yeah,
I know.
So
you can even open them more and they're still going to count.
Oh, yeah, that's why I have them. Just sitting.
It's only the ones that you obtain from tomorrow moving forward. The ones that, if you stack them up, they should still give gear.
All in all, go ahead.
I was just going to say, last week we talked about things to do. Make sure you're selling all your follower upgrades because they'll all be worthless.
True. And also, I mean, there's a lot that's changing with Legion. It's all going to be okay one way or the other. At the end of the day, sometimes it sucks and sometimes it doesn't. As long as we keep our head about us and don't freak out too much, I think it's going to be just fine. Some of you might get a little bit of a culture shock when you lock in tomorrow and realize that everything has changed with your class, but I promise it's going to be just fine. Just try to adapt and try not to freak out. And if it's bad, have faith, take it to the forums. There's going to be forums. There's pre-patch forums. It's on World of Warcraft's website. Just speak about it and help them make the game better. Instead of QQing in chat, just do something to make it better and it'll be fine. I promise. You okay
healing
there,
Lycan?
I'm thinking everything is awesome.
Everything is not awesome, but it is awesome when you are part of a team. Let's see. The new silence penalty.
Great chat's going to be a lonely place for a while.
Shit.
So, forever. Following the Legion pre-expansion, any player who is reported multiple times under the spam or abusive chat categories will, of course, after investigation, this is important to note, they're not just going to who used the word willy-nilly? I'm pretty sure that was Jim one time. They used the word willy-nilly. Somebody used the word willy-nilly, but they're not just going to randomly, when you hit the abuse button, that person's not going to instantly get blocked. There's an investigation that happens. They're going to receive an account-wide silence penalty. While this penalty is active, the silenced players will find their ability to chat with others greatly limited. And I'm just going to go through a couple of the differences. So silenced players will be unable to talk in instant chat. So party, raid, and battlegrounds. Talk in global channels. General chat, trade chat.
Is that overall, though? Like if I happen to silence, you know, Lycan in a raid, he's like screwed.
No, you can't silence him. This isn't an ability given to players. No. This is via somebody getting reported via the spam or abuse.
Okay.
And it's after it's investigated. So basically they'll pull the chat logs, they'll see, okay, this was in fact. So this isn't, you can't randomly silence a player, but that would be great if you could.
There's a lot of people about the silence.
They are unable to create calendar invites and events. Send in-game mail, send party invitations, send war game invitations, send invitations to duel.
I haven't played the game.
Update a pre-made group listing or create a list for a pre-made group. Silenced players are able to whisper friends. So WoW friends and Battletag friends. You can reply.
So you can still be a douche to them.
Yeah, you can still be a douche via private whisper. But they have to be friends with them. So if you're WoW friends with just like a character versus the Battle.net, then you can whisper them. Or if you're friends with them via the Battle.net, you can reply to whispers from non-friends. So if the person you're antagonizing whispers you, you can then continue the harassment via the whisper if that person chooses to leave that communication open. Here's what's weird. Party and raid chat with invited players, but it specifically says you can't talk in instant chat. I don't. I'm confused.
LFR. That's what they're trying to say. It's like,
okay.
Because I'm going to throw him under the bus. If I, silence Sauce and Secret's, silenced because of all the things I did, and I meet him up in an LFR, he can't talk.
Okay, that makes sense.
But if I invite him to a raid or to a random battle, say a dungeon that we're going to run together, then yes, he would be able to speak in raid chat.
They can talk in global party channels that have a moderator.
I didn't even know yet. I've seen that happen.
Maybe. I don't really know what is that. I don't know.
Invited chats.
Okay. Okay.
Remember in raid, I used to have a tank chat and I used to have a healer chat.
Oh, you're right. You did. And then you could also share quests if you're silent. Right. So I do appreciate that they're making the effort.
They talk in guild?
I
don't think so. No. And I think that that's a good thing. Our guild specifically has been the victim of a lot of harassment in trade chat over the last 2 years. So this is nice because little has been done to stop that issue. Unfortunately, as much as our guildies have reported it, we're constantly attacked by another guild publicly, which is kind of crappy. I'd rather you just do it privately. But I think that this is nice for repeat offenders. Hopefully Blizzard does their due diligence with their investigation and does it randomly. Like, I feel like I'm going to go on there right now and report Jim a bunch of times and just see if I can get Jim a bank silenced.
They'll say, whoa, he's too nice.
He's too great. We'll never silence
him. You've pep battled against him.
I know.
Who is this guild that we speak of? I want to know after the show.
He's terrible. They're terrible people. He's the same. We'll talk about that after show. I don't think, Jimmy, I don't think you've ever known the whole story, actually. You'll be interested in that story.
Get yourself an energy drink, so you're going to be there for a while.
It's not too bad, actually. Sit down, Jim. He's been quite quiet lately. He's been quite quiet lately, but it's probably because his mom didn't buy him game time, so that could probably be the reason.
Burn.
It happens. I'm sure he'll watch this, and he'll be like, I just hate Belle.
Negative.
Token. Wow, token.
Okay, so the NA qualifiers happened this weekend, and it was a beautiful thing, although a lot of the people in the third cup I didn't really know prior to this, which that's why you watch this, right? You find the new up-and-coming guys, the new guys that are hitting the PvP scene with them lifting these restrictions, with you not having to be on the ladder to be able to qualify. This is really nice because this gave players that you wouldn't normally see here, gave them the opportunity to kind of put together a team and go ham and see what they're capable of. I really appreciate that. Was Grin there? No, unfortunately, there was some. The way his bank account's set up is he's got a checking and a savings. Takes about 3 days to transfer from your savings to your checking.
Grin's good at PvP, but he's not like cup qualifier.
I think he had team. There was a team cohesive issue. At first, they thought they were anti-Canada. Then it was just a fluke where Blizzard accidentally forgot to name Canada as one of the OK people minus Quebec. Quebec is like, no. But there was a small. But I think they just decided since it was so late that they were just like, we'll try it again next year. So for that, for cup one, let's just give it a little recap and then we'll talk about where we're going to go from there. So the cup one, two, and three was for the finals. Okay. This is for North America. We're going to go over EU in just a second. So for cup one, we had NG Gaming Red and NG Gaming Black, which is Northern Gaming. And, I think Northern Gaming Red took cup one. And then for cup two, you had Tempo Storm and Method and very sad loss. Very sad loss for Method. It was very sad.
No.
Tempo Storm did take the win, but they both moved on, so that's okay. And then for Cup 3, you had Tertastic and Jail, which is really funny because Lore kept saying, $6,000 goes to Jail. And he was like, I don't know why he kept making all these Jail jokes. It was quite funny. But so all of those teams are going to move on to the North American Finals, which is going to be October 8th and 9th. So
my birthday.
From that final set, that decides who The road to BlizzCon continues. That decides who goes and does the things at BlizzCon, which, of course, is the whole reason we do this. $100,000, guys. $100,000 for the winning team at BlizzCon. I would like to sign up.
It's threes, right? Or was it five?
It's threes. It's threes, but they're allowed a four-man roster. So they can have a fourth. But, yeah, it's threes. Now,
can we ask Grin to stop messaging me? I'm doing the show. Jeez, Grin.
For EU.
You're good at PvP.
For EU, this is the road to the regionals, the European regionals, leading to BlizzCon. We've seen a Destro in EU, guys. There was a Destro making the dream happen. Somebody messaged me. I'm pretty sure it was PB and Justice. He messaged me and he's like, dude, there's a Destro in the EU finals. And I'm like, you want to know why? Because EU are badass motherfuckers. They don't care what people say. They're going to do whatever they want. Now, I don't really know how far the Destro got, but I was just super happy knowing that the Destro dream may or may not be real because there was in the cup. So for cup one, we had four languages in Method. Those guys are moving on to the regionals. Method did take that win. Then for cup two, you had ABC and ABC and ball jugglers. ABC took that win, but both ABC and ball jugglers are going on to the regionals.
Such a name right there.
And then for cup three, you had Northern Gaming Blue and Toxic Youth. Northern Gaming did take that win, but they do move on. The European regionals are September 28th. I hear you typing. The European regionals are going to be September 28th, and they actually do that at Warcraft, at Twitch's Warcraft channel. So make sure you guys check that out. So look at all these. There's snapbacks everywhere, and I'm just here like I don't have.
There's only like two. Probably only mine.
Do you have a snapback, bloke?
No.
Sorry,
secret sauce is one of a kind.
Not everyone has snapbacks. Not every hat is a snapback.
Every jerk has a snapback, and I'm sitting with four of them, so I'm sure you all have them.
Don't you have a snapback too?
My husband has a snapback, thank you very much, and he is in fact a member of the jerk squad.
All right, yeah.
Not only is he the president, he's a member.
He's the creator, actually. He's the creator of the Jerk Squad. Okay, so there was a Q&A. It was Jeremy, actually. Boy, was I way wrong. Poor Jeremy. I'm sorry. Jeremy is the lead developer, right? He's the lead World of Warcraft developer, but they focused on the world quests. They talked a little bit about the demon invasions, nothing we didn't already know. So let's talk about the world quests. So world quests are going to be updated throughout the expansion. This is important to note that as we're progressing, I'm assuming patches are probably going to bring new quests. There's probably going to be a lot of things that bring these new world quests. So it's good to know that they're going to keep the content flowing. As we talked about, the fishing tournament will be returning as a world quest. There's a couple questions. One of them was asked, will World Quest be a viable alternative to dungeons and raiding for gear or other items? Yes, but it's up to you as a player to opt into what you want to do in order to progress as far as getting gear as a player. The harder the content, the higher the item level of your gear is going to be. So if you're just using World Quest as a means to get your gear, you're going to get some stuff, but it's not going to be what you need. You need to be doing dungeons and raids in order to be acquiring that gear. So yes, you'll be able to get, we're going to just call it basic bitch gear because I don't really know what else to call it. But if you want... Walker? Yeah, if you want the, the starter gear. If you want the good stuff, you're going to need to do the high level content. You're going to need to do the raiding. You're going to need to do the dungeons, and you're going to need to take advantage of the new challenge modes with the Keystone system, which we'll talk about the Keystone system probably in another show because a lot's changing there. And the new Mythic Dungeons Plus. There's like all kinds of stuff. They're really giving you several ways. If raiding's not necessarily your get down, you could focus on some Mythic Dungeons and then get the plus version of that. Or you can do the challenge modes with the Keystones. You get the Keystone and unlocks and gives you a chest piece out of your order haul. They're really kind of giving you several ways to go towards this gear, but it's not going to be easy each way, right? Draenor, I think they were just throwing gear at us, right? Like, here, take my gear. Don't really do a whole lot for it. Just get here. You have what you need. Here, they've kind of brought it back to basics and balanced it out a little bit and said, okay, we're going to make sure that you raiders are rewarded for doing your hardcore raiding. We're not just going to give the guy who goes over here and just does world questing the same gear as you because that's not fair. We're not going to give the guy that's doing the guy that's doing crafted gear, he's going to be able to be a little bit better than the other people because we want to make crafted gear important.
They'll be viable to a degree.
But it's not going to be as much as if you're, say, a heroic mythic raider. So they've kind of brought it back to basics Well, you are a mythic raider, so you are going to be top
my gear. My gear is going to be through the roof.
You went 13-13, didn't you?
He went hard, dude.
That's it.
Then he went after Jimma with his pep battles. He's just attacking everybody full hilt.
Yeah, that's it. Just on a side note there, I got 1,000 pep battles achievement the other day.
I saw that.
I've only got 5,000 and something to go.
I need Jimma to help me.
I would gladly. I can't win
a PvP battle to save my life. I can't.
It's like I gave you two specific pets a year ago to do PvP
pet
battles.
And I forgot, and I did it, but I don't think I did it in the right order. You're going to have to, after the show,
I would be more than happy to sit down.
Does that mean that you're then coming for my title, Belle?
No. Possibly. I want to learn at the hands of the master, and Jim is the guy to go to get shit done when it comes to pet battles. So
let me give you
clearly it works.
There's a way to glitch it. There's a way to glitch it. Just go in with 3 Unborn Valkyrie, cast Unholy Ascension on all 3 of them, instant win.
You mean Unborn Valkyries?
That doesn't sound very fun.
And 3 Unholy Ascensions, you know, one after another, and you win.
Belle
doesn't have that pet. No.
I'm pretty sure I do. I'm pretty sure Aja gave it to me for my birthday 2 years ago.
You have to catch it.
Oh, you have to catch it? Okay, then I don't have it. It's one of the most rare ones.
It's pretty unique.
So you're trolling me then. Gotcha.
Lycan doesn't troll. I think he was just trying to give a suggestion and it wasn't as effective
as he knew I didn't have that. He knew I didn't have that. Unless I could buy it or somebody could give it to me, he knows I don't have those pets. What a jerk.
You know how funny it would have been to see people in the comments going in to PvP pet battlings, casting Unholy Ascension, watching their unborn Valkyries die or Valkyries die?
I won't let it happen as the
pet. Oh, is that the skill that will do a lot of damage but it'll kill their pet? Wow, what a jerk.
If you were a dinosaur, you'd be a Jerkosaurus.
That was a good one.
Another question.
Tweets all his achievements, and I miss it sometimes, so he'll have to make another comment underneath at Jimma Banks to make sure I catch it. I'm like, oh, sorry, bloke, I see that.
It hurts.
Another question is, how do you plan on incentivizing world quests when people have lots of gear and will be done with order resources? You'll basically never be done with order resources because artifact knowledge... Yeah. And research. So, and this is because you're going to be doing alts. Like Jimma right now is working on, I think, Resto or Mistweaver, right? So you're going to be constantly working on different alts, different specs. You could have all 3 specs and use the artifact power since it's soulbound. So generally, are we doing origami? Is that what that
is? We might be.
Dollar bills.
Jen, you guys are killing me. Generally, we'll want to give people far more world quests than they can complete in a day. So basically, you can choose what you want to do and always have something to do. Bonus events will be turned off for a while when launch happens to make room for new Legion bonus events. So when Legion happens, obviously the other stuff, the Pexis, all that other crap that we've been doing, that's not going to be needed because it's a new expansion. So I'm assuming they didn't really say for sure what they were going to be doing for those, but they are going to be redoing the system to make it Legion appropriate, which is going to be pretty nice. Maybe world quests will be a part of that. Not really sure what they're going to do in that regard, but they're coming back with some new stuff. So just remember, you won't have your monthly, once Legion hits, you won't have your monthly events to do that stuff. Will there be world PvP quests? Yes, and there are some crazy arenas to PvP in, riding combat, PvPing as a Murloc, etc., etc. So I watched him talk about this, and yeah, there's... Each zone has a PvP spot, right? They have a spot when you enter, it tells you you're about to enter the PvP zone. When you do this, and some of these quests take you to these zones, which is kind of fucked up when you think about it, but kind of funny at the same in the same aspect, because it's just it they want people to do a little bit of PvP, right? Even if you're on a normal server, those of us that are on a normal server, sometimes we miss that world PvP element. So this gives you that option. If you don't want to do it, you just stay away from the little camps. But each map has a little world PvP spot, and there's going to be questing that's going to take you there. PvE, PvE, PvEVP. Also, That was a lot to say. Did I really say that?
Tongue twister. Do it three times.
Yeah, you'll be able to do PvP while riding combat. Not really sure what that's about, but I'm totally intrigued. And then PvPing as a Murloc. I mean,
I'm guessing the riding combat would kind of be like the mount or like
maybe like a joust, right?
Grand. No, like in the grand.
Oh, you're right.
Or just down your mount.
It's the whole aerial battle thing from Wrath of the Lich King all over again.
I'm pretty excited, though, because I think it gives you... Here's what they're doing. They've given you so much to do in an expansion already. Just with the things that we've known about... And there's still stuff they haven't even told us yet, right? Like, they've hit us with a lot of things. If somebody says they're bored 2 weeks after a Legion launch, I'm going to have to ask for some credentials, because they've...
They don't have it.
This is... Right. This is just another element of throwing things at us to get us out of our comfort zone, to step us into not being bored, to pull us outside of our just the little things that we do in game. And I think that's really neat.
Do I understand it right? So basically it's forcing different factions, like Horde and Alliance, to go to the same area for those quests, right? To you basically have to fight each other, right?
And I'm not sad about it.
No, that's awesome. That's exactly, especially for the people who want world PvP. It's like, okay, go to this area.
And you get to have the best of both worlds. You don't have to level on a PvP server to have your little PvP fix. Like, there's sometimes when I would like to follow somebody because they irritated me, and I would like to follow you to a PvP zone, and then I would like to pew-pew you, right? I am that guy. Well, I will stalk you.
So, like, the Isle of Keldanos all over again.
Yeah, yeah. But, and that's cool. That's why I watched the show for that intro. So it's going to be pretty cool.
Neato.
And then for Jimma here, our pet battle world quest tied to anything other than pet progression. Yes, you get charms and tokens, but you can also contribute. You can also get gold, artifact progression, and finishing emissary quests.
So that's some stones to level up your pets, and it's very cool. I like it.
World quest will also, huh?
I was gonna say there's actually a quest that requires you to pet battle in a way too. It's in one of the zones.
Ooh,
not going to give spoilers away, but yeah, it actually, there is a NPC in the game that in order to complete through that, you actually have to complete a pet battle mini game. Not like a game, but it's actually a pet battle that you go into. And yeah, it's in order for you to progress through this one zone, you have to do this. So they're trying to introduce more people to the pet battling as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting.
It's always fun when I'm sad about the events. I know why they're holding off on the events for a while, but every pet battle bonus event, the channel, it's like triple in views. It's like people are looking to power level their pets.
That's neat. World quests will be geared for groups as well. So there's going to be several world quests where you'll have to kill really hard to down rares, dungeon bosses, world bosses, and you can share these quests, the world quests, you can share them with up to 5 people in a group. So obviously if you're trying to 25 man these world quest, is not going to fly, but you can do it in the normal 5-man group, which is nice, because then
how many do we have on the show right now?
We have a 5-man group, guys.
Oh my god, let's end the show. Let's go.
Let's see, we have a tank. Do you want to heal Jimma?
Jimma's a healer.
I'd prefer to heal. I'm not good off spec DPS with my
I can chaos bolt, so.
Well, first of all, I can tank and DPS, and I don't need any freaking heals. I'm a DK.
Fair enough. All right.
I was going to say, as a Rune Master, I could tank. What, Blow?
You also don't need more than 2 fingers.
Here, I got 2 fingers for you right here, buddy. Valid. Here's your 2 fingers.
Which parts of the pre-launch event will be gone when Legion launches? During pre-launch, you will have an explosive experience. Now, this is a quote, an explosive experience. Hope he's talking about the good explosive. And several sets of quests that unlock our pre-launch event, period. Unique stuff for folks playing in that time. If you come back after August 30th, it's a pretty long experience. So we're gonna shortcut it for you. If you come back later, basically shortcut to the end of that story. But the beginning of that final part that takes you to Broken Isle. That said, if you want to go back and do the whole thing, you can talk to the archivist in Dalaran and you can re-experience it. Demon invasions,
that's kinda cool.
Demon invasions and loot and toy and pet battles will be gone, though. Or battle.
Pet
battles. So what you get from that will be gone if you want to go back and experience it if you didn't sub. So for those of you that ask, should I sub? There's your answer. Yes, you should sub.
The answer is always yes.
You always say always yes to the dress, right? Say yes. So, and you'll get...
Oh, yeah? Where's your dress at?
Yeah. I was going to say, you brought it up. Oh, let's put the spotlight on her. Where's your dress, eh?
Everybody acts like it's not going to be done. If Belle gives her word that I'm going to put on a fucking dress, Belle's going to put on a fucking dress. Somebody messaged me the other day. They're like, so you're going to renege? What? What does that even mean? And they're like, so you're not going to do it? And I'm like, seriously, people, calm down. So yes, guys, dress shopping. I already started my dress shopping. I didn't really see anything that was Belle appropriate because a lot of it's strapless, guys. I can't really do strapless. I could do like a thin strap. I'm working on it. I promise you the dress is going to be worth it. It's going to be worth it. Let me work it.
I knew that was coming. This is how it's going to go, guys. Secret sauce is the healer. Lycan doesn't want to tank. I'll tank. We got our three DPS. No.
I'll tank.
Oh. Well, who's going to
heal? You want to tank, though?
I will.
Secret sauce. Jimmy, you're gonna have to heal. Guys, breaking news. Jim is going to have a demon hunter.
Are you going to heal with a demon
hunter? You and everybody else.
Oh, secret sauce is the healer. He's the big raid guy on the show. He should play his proper spec.
You're right.
I thought Lycan didn't want to tank. I am only really a Mistweaver on my monk, but I will be killing stuff with an alt.
How to throw one of your co-hosts on under the bus. You know, I would be a proper raid member too, but I messaged somebody last week about getting an app or where to find the app, and he never responded. So
that's because we posted the app in the guild group, to which you never pay attention to. Because if you did, you would have seen it. The two different posts that we did for raids.
I don't think you're.
Also, if you go to theWritersOfRohan.com and go to recruitment, you will see the app that you need to apply right there.
I think you would expect a friend to message you back after a week. But
that's what you guys are doing. Maybe he didn't see your message. Belle let you know where it is. You can now apply. I think
Lycan does not pay attention to anything on Facebook, no matter what group it's in. He literally, when I post something in the officer group, 2 weeks later he'll be like, "Hey, so what do we do about this?" I don't know.
Let's be easy on the guy. Be happy he knows how to work a computer. Like, tell him where to apply.
You can text me. So, thewritersofrohan.com, go to the recruitment tab. Boom. Everything you need. All the applications you need for all the stuff, including RBGs. So, with that, let's keep it on task. Liking. World quest gear item level. As you increase your personal item level, you increase the potential item level of the gear you can get. This is something we talked about a few episodes ago, where they are taking your current item level for world questing into consideration.
Say that again.
Remix.
So because they're taking that into consideration, if you have, it's not going to drop the same item level gear. So you have the opportunity to improve. So if you've gotten gear, you know, rating, or you gotten gear here and your item level's boosted, when you get gear drops, it's going to be on par with that. So it's not just going to be giving you a bunch of crap that you can vendor. And the reason being is because these world quests, they want you to do them forever, right? They always want you to be doing these new world quests that they put in there. So they have to make sure that what they're giving you is a viable reason for you to keep doing it, and not just do a bunch to get gear and then have nothing to do. You know, 3 months into the expansion, well, why should I do world quests? Well, you're going to always want to do world quests, because the higher your personal item level goes, the higher the gear that you get to drop. So,
right.
Gear drops and lollipops and rainbows, everything.
That's really disturbing.
Did you watch Charlie and the Chocolate Factory just now?
No, but on that note, I like the original mostly.
So that's pretty much the majority of the news that we have for today. I'm going to talk about PvP for Belle's Bites, but I'm pretty sure we don't have a lore section today, but we'll be back next week with lore. But Jimma Banks should have a nice PvP or pep battle.
And before that, make sure everyone hashtags more lore to Lycan. More lore. More lore. Right? You want me to talk about pep battles? I think I could do that. Pep battle bonus event. Ladies and gentlemen, last one before the end of the expansion. Let's talk PvP pep battles. Belle, I need you listening. Get off your phone.
I got you. I'm not even on my phone.
No, I'm just joking. I don't have a lot of like specific lists. There's a huge variety of pets to PvP pep battle with, actually. And I think that's one of the even people who pep battle, like those, you know, a lot of people enjoy pep battles overall, but they stay away from the PvP pep battles. It's like the unknown, right? So Blizzard is trying to make everyone kind of do that by getting 5 wins for the event. And then you, you know, you get your stone, you get a free max level tune. So I actually did not get a chance to do my 5 wins so far. I've been super busy with just life and...
Shame on you. Yeah, walking.
And beta. Yeah, I walk a lot. Actually, got a... So anyways, a lot of beta, but...
They got apps out there to track your walks.
Yeah, I've been.
I will literally shut this entire show down if you keep going.
I'm not joking.
Part
of this event.
I'm not even kidding you.
Anyway, everyone shut your mouths. I'm trying to talk here.
I'm going to remove you right now. I'm not even joking. This is my serious face.
We're very serious. And so are we, actually, right now.
We are talking pet metal.
Of course.
I'm going to kill everybody that's in this call right now.
There's such a large variety of pets to do. I don't have an official list. And I get that question a lot, you know, either what are the best pets for PvP pet battles or what are the best pets to just have overall in your collection to power level pets. So I am going to work on a big list and make an article for the PDQ and just have that broken down. But there really is a large list of them. Currently, right now, in the state of PvP pet battles, even though I mentioned there's a huge list, there's a lot of pets that need a nerf, and they're getting a nerf. So if you're kind of frustrated with that, you know, in Legion, it'll be fixed. And if you are, you know, a little afraid or, you know, timid to do PvP pet battles, again, don't be afraid to ask. There's a lot of people in the PDQ community or on the PWNCAST channel that will respond. I know Lycan was doing his PvP pet battles, yeah. And he was asking, you know, what we thought were good or whatever. I was wondering, actually, Lycan, what did you end up using and how did it go?
For mine, I went 10 for 10 pretty quickly because I was, just because I was doing the Pandarian ones this weekend as well. You know, side note, I actually raised, I want to say 75 pets from 1 to 25 so far this week. Ooh. And I still haven't even logged in. But you can go from, on these pet battle weekends, if you have the hat, if you have the pet treats, both of them, you can go from 1 to, like, 21 in one battle.
Awesome.
And that's all, yeah. And so, I mean, when you start, like, Bell knows not to bother me when I'm in Pandaria because I'm not going to pay attention anyway because I'm pet battling. But when I make my circuit, that's, what, an easy 8 or 9, 10 pets just from doing one circuit in one battle each.
Nice. It's such good experience. I'm lazier, and I don't even finish them all. I'll do, like, the close ones, and I'm like, meh.
Yeah, you put in a lot of hours for doing it, so like...
But once you have it set up, though, like, there are add-ons out there like Rematch. I use Rematch religiously, because as soon as you go up to a pet battle trainer, you mouse over, boom, it automatically switch your pets. Put your pets in, put your leveling pets in. For the PvP aspect side of it, I was using...
Oh, there's an add-on that manages your pet choices?
When you go, say, like, a Key of the Chosen is right there in Valley of the Four Winds. And not Valley of the Four Winds, but the middle part there in Pandaria. If you go up to her and you mouse over and you've already faced her and found a good team that beats her, it'll actually put your pet battle teams in her. And then you can actually associate the one spot to put your leveling pet in her. Yeah, so once you've leveled that one to 25 and you've got a whole queue of them listed, the next time you go to visit that trainer, it automatically puts those two pets back in her plus your leveling pet again.
Awesome.
And your new one. But with the PvP aspect, I was actually using, I did use Graves. I finally got around to using it. Creepy Crate.
Nice.
Just for the Bone Storm, and there's another AoE. And I want to say the third, I can't remember who the third one was, but I know.
You were talking about using the healing one, the magical Crawda that, did you end up using that or something else?
You were going to say Crotch, weren't you?
No, I was going to make a shot at Asmongold because he was like, I went on a 100-game win streak, and he's like, do you know the magical Crawdad? And, like, you just threw the healing team at me when it's not even that powerful, but...
I did go in, and like you said, after I had whispered you that, I went in with the magical Crawdad. I went in with Emerald Protowhelp.
Nice.
And I forget what the third big healing pet was, but as I go in there... Oh, it was the Neither Sprite Dart or Dartling, the one that has the life exchange?
Yeah, the Sprite Darter Hatchling?
Sprite Darter Hatchling. Sorry, there's like two of them that are very similar. And I actually
went
with that.
Yeah, the Nether Fairy Dragon.
Yeah, and they got pissed. It took so long to get through the pet battles. The team wasn't dying. I might have had one or two pets die here or there. But
yeah,
like you said, it's just not worth it. It's not worth spending 15 minutes on a PvP pet.
Sometimes, yeah, he asked about the magical Crawdad, which is a healing pet, right? And it's cool to try to out-heal the damage. But if you're trying to rack up some wins, they're longer pet battles, right? So
and not
huge
with
list.
Not with the one wish ability it has, and then renewing mists where it heals you over time, and then does half your pet. No, it's not worth it.
Yeah, and I used to, because I've recorded every pet battle bonus event, the very best quest games. I recorded all of them for the channel, and I used to take requests from viewers to try the different combinations and try to show, hey, if you maybe use the moves differently or have a specific breed of that pet, you can actually do better. So, like, if you're doing PvP pet battles, rematch is great. Pet tracker will show you the abilities from your opponent's pet, so you get a heads up. And fast pets are really good because you want to be able to attack first. The more speed a pet has, the faster you are. It's very not much, but I think once I finally have that article complete for an official list for PvP pet battles and for power leveling, it'll really just answer a lot of people's questions. Instead of me trying to freestyle a list, I can say, hey, here's the article, go there, boom, right? So not much about PvP pet battles. I hope everyone enjoyed their last pet battle bonus event. And
I did. I totally participated much.
You lied. Tell the truth, did you?
Oh,
you
gosh.
Did, so did I.
I checked the calendar and I logged out.
Yeah, don't be all willy-nilly on us and make, min-max in our responses based on what you're saying. So
it's not cool. I like how you snuck that in there.
So
I was keen on that.
Now you've talked about your pet battles. Let's talk about PvP. So recently, I did do more than just a video for PvP. I did do a full-fledged article on the PDQ because I felt like it was important for people. PvP is so emotional for people that I feel like unless you're going in with all the information, it's really important for you to be educated and not to listen to people who may not understand, right? It's really easy for someone to think they understand the concept and then they panic you. They think all these things and then you're pretty negative about something that you're not even sure you're supposed to be negative on. So with that, I'm not sure who you're pointing at. I'm thinking, Jim?
About who not to listen to about PvP or PvP.
Yeah, so I did a nice little, I mean, I'm pretty proud of it. I did do an article on the PDQ for it to go along with the video. So I wanted to summarize it. I wanted to talk about, I'll link here. It'll be right here somewhere. You guys can go watch the video and stuff. But I wanted to just highlight a couple of the things for those of you that listen to the show, and this is where you get your news from. As of the new PvP system in Legion, there'll be no more PvP currency. So there will be no more honor. There'll be honor, but not honor as we know it. We'll talk about that in a second. So there's going to be no more conquest. You will be able to get you'll be able to get Mark of Honor, which the Mark of Honor, it randomly drops from one of the boxes via the RNG gods. Now the Mark of Honor is how you can purchase old PvP gear. That'll be the only currency technically. So the way that the way that you'll get your PvP gear is going to be via the boxes. So you're going to have to get your Battleground Victory bonus box and your Arena Victory bonus box. That will randomly drop piece of gear that you may or may not be able to use. This is us relying a whole lot on a lot of things, and I'm going to choose to keep the faith because I watched the PvP video with Holinka, and he gave me a lot of faith. Whether or not it's in vain, we won't know that until the time comes to pass. But honor levels are going to be the main focus here in PvP. So you are going to be getting honor, but it's not the traditional way you think. It's actually going to be honor points, which is going to go towards your honor level. Now, there's a total of 50 honor levels that you can acquire. So from honor level 1 to honor level 50, I did a nice breakdown on the PDQ as to which...
I like that breakdown.
Did you see that? I really worked hard on the PvP part because it's not easy for me to do PvE stuff because I don't really PvE, but the PvP stuff I could do the guides in my sleep because that's just how I roll. So gaining these honor levels, it's important because that's how you unlock your talents. So it's incremental. I think it's like first one, you get your medallion. Your very first one, when you max out at 110, you automatically get your medallion without having to do anything, which is your trinket. So that's important that they gave you that right off the bat. And then I think like level 3, level 4, they're just really, the incremental system that they chose is kind of weird. But it's important to note that it's easy to go from honor level 1 to 20 really quickly. It's really small amount of honor that's required. I think in the video you'll see I did the breakdown. I think for like an arena, rated arena, I think you get like 350 honor to go towards your honor points, and RBG it's like 450. I did in the video, I tooltipped and show you guys, you know, what you get them from skirmishes, you get them from randoms as well, so you don't have to do the rated stuff. Obviously the rated stuff's going to award you more honor points, but right, that's not going to be the make or break over you guys being able to get them. Obviously we also know that the prestige system is happening. It's really important for me to point this out. Prestige is not something that's going to be a requirement. So if you get your honor level 50 and you've unlocked all of your talents, You don't have to prestige if you don't want to. Prestiging, 90% of it's going to be cosmetic. You get a different icon above your nameplate. You'll be able to get mounts. You'll be able to get pets.
Transmogs for your weapon.
The weapons. Oh, every weapon. Cool. The PvP version of every weapon is so beautiful. But you don't have to if you don't want to. It's not required for you to be a better PvPer in the sense of you're not going to get anything bonus related for you doing that that's going to help you PvP better. The prestige system is for those of you who want those accolades, right? 90% of the PvP, the people that actually PvP, it's also for accolades, right? We want the visual. I want to be able to walk into a major city and you know I'm a PvPer based off my gear, my weapon, and my icon. That's really the important thing of prestiging. So if you guys are freaking out and you're like, I don't want to do this, you don't have to. You totally can stop at the 50 and keep all your talents and be done with it. If right. you're going to be like me and I plan on grinding that out, I'm going to be without my talents, because once you prestige, it resets all your, you have to reacquire all your honor talents again. You get your one back of your
starter one.
Your starter one, which is your medallion, your trinket, but then you have to rework to get all that stuff. So cool. It's going to be a choice. You're going to have a little bit of pain and suffering going without your talents while you prestige, but totally worth it. If you time it just right too, you could do the prestige at the beginning of each week when you have to go in, and because you get you get two of the rateds for the arenas and you get two of the rateds for battlegrounds to be able to get extra bonus. So you get two a week. So if you time it just right, if you do the beginning of the week's reset for you to go and get your two to get the extra bonus, you can probably get back to good. Honestly, I think you'll acquire them really quickly, even in just random battlegrounds. We probably do 20, 30 a night when we actually sit down to do them, just the randoms without being rated. It's not always a good thing, I'm not going to lie to you, but I mean, if you're already going to do it,
might as well knock them all out.
Might as well get it done, and if you want a prestige, you can. Yeah. World PvP. Don't know if you guys knew in great detail, but Dalaran Sewers, a.k.a. the Underbelly, that's going to be a PvP. That's going to be a PvP zone. The second you step into a certain... stop it. Just stop moving.
Ooh.
David. I mean, secret sauce.
Ooh. That's not fucking me.
Somebody just sits still.
And it's not even me either.
I'm chewing like the smallest piece of gum.
It's something in your hand. You're tapping something on your hand because I can hear the feedback. See, it's not doing it anymore. Liar!
If I still hear the tapping,
So, Dalaran Sewers. This was a nice little element. It's important for those of us that are warlocks to know that where we think our order hall portal is located is not where it's located. So, originally, it was located in one spot. So, if you're looking at Wowhead for the portal entrance, I don't think that they've updated, but that entrance that we used to go through, which is right off the flight path pad, that's not where you go for your order hall. You're going to get murked if you go down there like I did. I just wanted to go to my order hall and do things, and I got literally murked. When you go down there, you get flagged, and you kill all the people, kill everybody.
Right.
Now, there's going to be an NPC there that you can bribe, and you can bribe him with Sightless Eye. Sightless Eye, you can acquire them from killing rares. You acquire them from different NPCs that you kill. I put a nice list of everything you needed to know on where you can get these Sightless Eyes from. It takes 20. You can bribe the NPC who's the captain of the guard. You can bribe him to either have the guards there or have the guards go away. So, basically, it's open.
They're never going to fucking be there.
Yeah, well, it's awful. But if the guards are not present, everybody's PvP. If the guards are there, then you're good, right? You have to duel and all that other stuff. But you can bribe to send the guards away or send the guards there, which you're right.
That's what I'm saying. They're never
always going to be those guys that are going to bribe it, and you might have 5 minutes of...
I will bribe them and fucking leave.
You're so mean. But it's another element.
I was going to say, this is his coming out. He's a little edgy these days, eh? I like it.
The Brexit.
A?
Did you say A?
He did say
A. Yes.
So, it's going to be important to know that you guys can go down there and get murked. So be very careful when treading the waters of the underground sewer, because it's a kill or be killed. I literally got murked and I was pissed off. Remedy had to try to come save me, and by then I had already, like, I rezzed and ran out of there. They killed me twice trying to run up the freaking stairs. And they don't care that it was an accident, right? They just see somebody and they're like, it's obvious it was an accident because you run, right? You reverse and you're like, oh shit, and you go to run and they give chase to kill you. Kind of a jerk move, but then again, that's just the nature of the beast, and that's what you do. That's what you do.
Yeah.
It was funny anyway, to be perfectly honest. So in regards to PvP, yes, a lot is changing. Yes, it is scary. Some of it might not be good. Some of it is good. Some of it we might not be happy about. Some of it we will be happy about. What I can tell you is they are paying attention to the PvP. This is something that's important to them because they're trying to make PvP a thing outside of BlizzCon. They want there to be PvP tournaments throughout the year. They want to focus PvP as an esports situation. So hopefully they'll continue to gear towards that. I personally am not unhappy with the new system. I think, Jim, you're the other like serious PvPer. Are you unhappy with the new system?
So I haven't gotten that deep into it. I like it. I was just going to make a joke. If they want it to be a big thing outside of... Yeah? Hey? If they want it to be a big thing outside of BlizzCon, they have to give us content, right? So I guess the good news, number one, is they're giving us content. And I like what I see so far. I haven't done Arena or Battlegrounds yet, so I'm excited. All the way in.
Well, it's hard to do it. It's hard to do it right now because it's still unbalanced. They're still tuning, right? They're going to be tuning all the way up until Legion. So I have been waiting to do my talent breakdowns for each PvP spec until right now because I think I'm okay. They've done a lot of pruning for the talents, but it's really difficult to kind of get any kind of gauge on power because the tune he's playing on now is probably going to be very different come launch because balancing and tuning, so it's just
adjust slightly. I'll probably be doing some PvP as Demon Hunter, Mist Weaver, and maybe the Death Knight.
Nice. Death Knights are always good. Doesn't matter, they're always good.
But I was hoping Lycan would play his Druid as his main, and then I'll bring my DK over and I'll be the DK of the group.
Make sure you guys make sure you guys go and check out the breakdown for all the information that you're going to need. I'll go ahead and post it here in the chat, and then you'll see it here. It is on the PDQ, and I did a video kind of just showcasing some things that's important for the PvPers just to kind of help you prepare so that you can kind of get your wrap your head around it, and then this week I'll be doing the specs for all the PvP talents. So I'm not really sure what's going on, and I feel like people aren't really paying attention because they're secretly talking to each other via other avenues because they're flipping each other off.
You don't know that. Why don't you ask us?
I was actually flipping Mrs. Lycan over off because she was trying to grab...
That's even worse.
I know. She was trying to grab something off my desk while I'm trying to do the show. She knows better than that.
She could do whatever she wants.
So, no, I was...
Happy wife, happy life.
Tune in next week, folks, to see Lycan with a black eye.
All right. Lycan, were you pointing down at yourself for PvP earlier?
Just point at your ass.
I was going to say that.
Pretty sure it was an insult for you.
I thought looking. I'm like,
hold a mirror up and reflect that shit, Jim.
So that's pretty much all I wanted to talk to you guys about that. I wanted to, especially since I just did the guide for it, I thought it was important that you guys knew what was going on. So.
The only thing I have concerns with it is people are not going to give it a chance. I like the changes. You know, I like the ideas of having
people say they're not even subbing because of the PvP changes.
That's why we have to stop talking about these damn people. I'm going to be aggressive, Jim. We keep talking about these guys who complain on the forums and complain. Stop talking about those people.
I'm addressing specific people passive aggressively.
I know, but who cares, Jim, what they're saying?
Even if those people left, you're still going to have
a new group of people. We have a World of Warcraft podcast that talks about that. That's why.
I know, but we're always like the...
I like the changes, though. I like the idea of it getting... People have always bitched that there's not been a separation between PvP and PvE.
Right, and now they are. Now you're getting that. Yeah.
Right. You're getting everything you bashed to.
Holinka posted, and I put that in the article. I linked back to Holinka's post. He did post the template and what that template means when you enter a PvP engagement. He didn't say they still haven't done anything for world PvP yet because they're trying to figure out a way to make that work. But he did post that template. So they've given, I don't know what that is, that noise is. Somebody needs to stop playing with stuff on their desk. Okay. So he did say that template will be activated when they enter PvP. So for Battlegrounds, for Arenas. And that also means that they'll quickly be able to fix an issue with a number, right? So if they mm-hmm. overbuffed one thing on accident, they could just go in there and change the number, and it'll change it specific for PvP. So Lycan's right. They did say they wanted it separated, and now they have done that. We don't know if that's going to be great. We just have to wait and see.
And that's what I'm saying.
Have to be open to change.
Right. Yeah, people are bitching about this so far, but you complain about the PvEers getting gear better than faster than PvPers. Well, they fixed that. You're complaining about your talents not matching up for what PvP should be. Well, they fixed that. Then you're complaining that, you know, what was the other thing? Oh, it was that the damage was not, if they fixed damage in PvP or PvE, it affected. And they mm-hmm. fixed that, you know? I love the changes. I can't wait to do a little world PvP. I can't wait to get into the battlegrounds. I mean, I'm not a hardcore, but I like to kind of delve into it. Mm-hmm. And I think the changes are just going to be wonderful. I mean, I haven't really messed with it in thingy, but it's, you know, give it a chance. It looks great. I mean, I love the whole system.
And I think that's a good point to end on, and then we'll move on into the end of show stuff. I think that's a good point is I'm really critical of Blizzard, right? And you hear me say Blizzard like 20 times a day. We're super critical because we're emotional about it, right? We're very emotional. We're emotional about changes. We're emotional about these things, and that's great. But I think Lycan's point too is they do listen. It might not be right away, right? And it might not always go our way. They still haven't fixed some things that I'd like them to fix for the Warlock, but they're not supposed to, because it's not just me that plays. There's a million other Warlocks over the world that are happy. They're happy with Affliction. They're happy with their changes. They're happy. And at the end of the day, they can't please everybody. The only thing that they can do is shoot fish in a barrel and pray to God that they hit the right fish. At the end of the day, that's all they can do. I'm not saying it's going to be great, guys. I'm saying from what I've seen in beta, I'm not disappointed. That's all I'm going to say. Not disappointed.
Not at all.
They might fall on their face with a couple things, right? Because everything's always great in beta. And then sometimes we get the real thing, right? It's a different beast when you're playing live. But I do have faith that it's going in the direction that it needs to go in. So that I'm happy about. So what a show. Jim has been very combative today. I don't know if
because I got a sunburn. Yeah. I'm a little uncomfortable
right now.
He's been
feisty. I like that feisty, though. That feisty's good because it gets your blood pumping.
Yeah.
It's good. So
I like the world quest. That's why I watched the show. I'm excited about the world PvP.
For the end of show stuff, we do have the Blokerton. I'm going to let him tell you about his thing. I'm going to link it in chat, and then I'm also going to put a link down here, so make sure you guys check it out. If you're listening to this on iTunes, you'll see the link in the description. If you're watching this on YouTube, you'll also see the link in the description. Bloke has something that he wants to share with you guys, and then we'll say our goodbyes and get out of here, because my family won't stay quiet any longer.
We're trying for you. Like
neither will my dad. He's over there making a hell of a racket. I've got to, like, that's why you can keep hearing the noise in the microphone. Swear jar. So this week with the help of Mrs. Hugebloke, we launched a web store of sorts. We're trying to raise the funds to get the Blokerton to BlizzCon. After having a rough year, instead of doing a GoFundMe or Kickstarter or any of those where it's like, yeah, I can't afford to go, give me money, we figured that we would take that same sort of track, but at least give something back to people in return. So we're offering up the iconic sort of Australian gear, you know, Vegemite, Tim Tams, all that sort of stuff in different packs to help chip towards getting my flights after job loss and surgeries and babies and moving houses and shitty Australian currency dollary dues and all the rest of it. It's proving to be a task. Thank you, Bell, for modeling one of the many variants of can coolers. But yeah, she's linked the website down there. Don't necessarily, like, if you can't afford to or don't want to, that's completely fine, but if you could share the message around and really just try and get it out there so people can see it, just to help get a bloke over there. It's not a cheap exercise coming from down here, and I haven't had the best luck this year, so but I understand that nothing's for nothing these days, so instead of asking for donations, we figured we'd give you back something to you know, sample a bit of Australia.
$20 Remedies will tell you that.
You would not believe what I'd do for $20 at the moment, I'll tell you that much.
BlizzCon just won't be the same.
So it's not, this isn't a like give bloke money stuff. This is a get something in return and help. help your fellow Australians.
Exactly.
Very expensive, like, for Australians to leave their country, right? Because planes and conversions, it's very expensive.
It's redonkulous. And so I went down and spoke to a couple of friends of mine, and they've managed to work out really good deals so that the money that is coming through these packs serves a large proportion of going towards the flights and accommodation and things like that directly. Yeah, because, I mean, who would have guessed, but apparently, you know, having babies and stuff like that where you haven't got a job actually turns out to be pretty expensive. And it wasn't meant to be like a... just a quick note, because I did notice a message from one person. It's certainly not a case of, oh, poor me, you know, I can't, help me out, whatever else. Like I said, if you don't want to do it, that's fine. I understand not everyone's in that position. But to that person in particular who said, don't go if you can't afford it, I'm going to say... fuck you.
Who said that? Oh, no, somebody said that in our chat?
No, that came via a private message.
Oh. And, nobody that watches us would ever say that.
It is a waste of time,
but sometimes it's okay to vent, Jim, yeah. And I think you forget that. When you're mad, it's okay to tell people, hi, you pissed me the fuck off. It's okay to be angry, and it's okay to call people out. It's healthy. Is,
but we're focusing plus, on getting the big bloker tin.
Wait till someone makes Jim mad. See, nobody's ever made Jim mad. Just
No, time out. People have made me mad all the time.
Nobody's ever commented mean to you on your channel.
Are you kidding me?
Is that a challenge?
Do you know how many people have made fun of my yas and yiggity? Trust me. Oh, yeah.
I don't believe that at all.
But I'm just saying, we're focusing on getting bloke to BlizzCon, and who cares about that one person? Right.
And bloke, the economy's terrible since, you know, what, Britain left the EU. I mean, sure, the rest of the EU's hurting, isn't it?
Oh, man.
Australia's by the EU and the Why don't you ever tell them not to be mean to me, Gemma? You're so focused on
that
you don't even defend my honor.
Well, Blake would call me a brown noser, so I can't. Let's talk about woke, okay?
That explains why all of a sudden I get it now. That makes perfect sense.
No, next episode.
You're supposed to be my BlizzCon husband. Good job.
You're already
doing a great job filling those shoes.
So. I'm your bro. Blake, continue.
That message was one person in particular, and you know, just to throw it out there that not everyone has been overly polite about the concept. I understand that I even saw it myself last year. There was a whole bunch of, like I said, GoFundMes and Kickstarters and this and that, and just people just flat out going, hey, I'm too poor, you know, put money in my wallet to go. And that's certainly not the case. So I really want to reiterate that this was the case of, like, I honestly believe nothing is for nothing in this modern era. And that's why we're giving back in terms of, like, Tim Tams and boomerangs and those stupid-ass cork hats that everybody seems to want for some unknown reason. But it will. It will all go towards to getting my lanky ass over to BlizzCon so I can have a twerk off with Belle.
Let me interrupt you and say why it's important. So, yes, to people who will say, well, just don't go. You're 100% right. You could just not go. You're absolutely right, except with what we do here at PWNCAST, his presence is needed. We do things and we do live shows and we do stuff, and it's only great if the whole group gets to go and see the fruits of their labor, which BlizzCon is essentially a year's worth of work that we get to celebrate as a group for the things that we've done. And a lot of our staff is going. At the end of the day, you're right. It could be a just don't go. However, I am behind it. I will buy from him just because I want to see my podcast partner there.
Really,
like, I want to see him go there. He needs to be there. It doesn't work if all your team is not present.
It really boils down to one simple fact, and that's just I've had shit luck since the last BlizzCon. That's all there is to it. Like I said, lost my job, different surgeries, kids, moving house, all that sort of stuff, and just haven't had a good run of luck. So I don't, you know, I normally. We normally budget and have all that sort of stuff. We're normally working full time and there's all that income. And that's just unfortunately not the way it's been this time around. So
that doesn't matter. And I'm going to tell you why. Lots of people have their entire trips to BlizzCon paid for that do group things like this because they have that funding. They have people that pay for it. There's lots of podcasters who get Kickstarters to be able to go to take their whole team that pays for their tickets, it pays for their flights. We didn't ask for everybody to be taken care of. we took care of each other. We all made sure that we could. Unfortunately, the Australia cost is bigger than what our collective wallets could help at the end of the day. And we need bloke there. That's just the reality.
I think at last count from where I live, it's about $1,300, which I can't translate that to American money off the top of my head, but it's not cheap.
Yeah,
that's just for the flight.
Yeah, the flight's the really crappy part. That's really, we could help him work with like the sleep arrangements. The food doesn't matter because we'll always make sure he can eat collectively. But the flight really is the crap part because that's a lot of money.
So I want to say just quickly in advance too, there's a couple of people that have already bought them, and one person in particular sent me a message and said, "Look, don't even bother sending the pack." And he even went to the extent of putting two different addresses, so I don't know which one to send it. just purely because he wanted to help out, and I want to say thank you to those people. They know who they are. So
if you want
to
help. He's not asking for anything for free. He's offering something in return. If you don't want to help, you don't have to. You're not obligated, and we won't hate you if you don't.
I give out free hugs at BlizzCon.
I will show my boobs on Twitch if that helps.
No, he won't. That's a lie. Don't tell people. I never said
your channel.
I'll do it right now.
And two, will you have anything in these boxes with Arnold Schwarzenegger being that he's an Aussie too?
He is Austrian. Isn't that different?
He's an Aussie. No, it's the same thing.
Even I know that's not right.
Hook, line, and sinker every so time, though.
I hate you all.
Every time.
I'm particularly unhappy with all of you today.
What?
Particularly unhappy.
That grinds my gears.
The fuck are you talking about? I've been quiet for like the past 20 minutes.
I love you, Secret. You want to know why? Because you haven't been here long enough to irritate me. Just wait a year and then you'll be good.
Yes. Have you not heard his desk and the plastic
rolling all of it, all the show? Amount of sound aggro that's happened this episode. If I were...
I hit my fucking elbow. Fuck that. And I don't have a cup full of ice.
We gotta start an F-bomb counter for David, eh? He's loosey-goosey these days.
I will fucking raid lead it like I did fucking on Sunday all over again.
Guys.
Bell.
We are gonna go ahead and end on that note because I'm getting dirty looks from Dark from there because it's...
Well, you
it's
tell Dark to wait up for the week of WoW.
He doesn't care. Oh, we'll not do the week in WoW. Okay, let's do the week in WoW and then we will... It's your guys' fault because we were 15 minutes late. Lycan... What did you do this week?
Why is it our guys' fault? We determined that the technical issue had nothing to do with the four of us.
It was your hearing that made us late, though.
Negative ghostwriter. It was not my hearing.
65 pets up to level 7, or level 25. Plus,
hacks,
I've been doing...
Hacks, cheating hacks. Yeah.
Archaeology. Just
following my guides.
I'm ready to slash wrist on archaeology. I've got... so many more achievements. I think I'm up to like almost 21,600 achievements now. And a lot of that's just been fusing. I've been on my druid, because let me tell you, if you're going to do archaeology achievements, dude, on a druid flight form is unbelievably so much faster. So I go through and been doing this, and I'm close to getting Seeker of Knowledge title.
Nice.
Which is getting all the pristine artifacts in Pandaria. I have two left, and they are going to be the bane of my existence, but I'm close to doing that. Been spending a lot of time on beta, except for today when my character got stuck in the nether and is now disappeared. But, hey, I'm back. But, yeah, lots of achievements. I can't wait till tomorrow. Just really looking forward to clearing up all the bag space that I have and getting rid of all the shit that I have been hoarding for the last, 10 years of stuff that I really don't need.
Sorry, one of my kids has a fever, so I was texting instructions. Bloke, what did you do this week in WoW? You're moving, so I don't even know if you've actually been in WoW.
I actually got to play WoW in between moving. And I'm genuinely terrified of what's going to happen when a particular person that's usually pretty aggressive about that sort of thing finds out. I snuck a couple of mount runs. I did my pet battles and got like 1,000 pet battle achievement thing. Did because I spent a lot of time holding little bloke so that Mrs. Scary Bloke can sleep. I've become the master of one-handed archaeology and just using the mouse to fly around and do all that stuff, because there's a whole bunch of those that still need to be ticked off from Pandaria. It's a time killer, and I get to have snuggles with the little fella. But I also had I was privileged to be online at a time when Knights of the Dark Age wrapped up their Mythic run for this year. Obviously, with the patches, they got 10 of 13, so they're not quite as hardcore as I am. But they did really well to finalize up before the patch. Congrats to you guys. And that was pretty much it. Didn't get a lot of time to play. There was other activities, moving, Pokeballs, you know, that sort of chewed my time up this week. But, yeah.
Awesome. Gemma?
One-handed archaeology.
One-handed archaeology is more efficient than you like, and I bet you use both hands. But, so, shout out to the homie Asmongold. I thought I'd be doing more raiding myself. I'm not one to really ask for handouts. I felt like asking for a heroic Archie kill for the mount is, I just didn't want to ask for it, right? So I did ask Asmongold. The homie hooked me up. He did the Moose's Loose run. So shout out to him. Probably one of the biggest guests we've had on PwnCast. So shout out to him. I don't like how you gotta, I still haven't done the quest. You get an item and you gotta go follow through the quest line. I know it's not long, but Jim was like, WTF. And then, so I've been doing beta as well. Two special ladies I want to shout out. Simri Jones, I spoke about her 2 weeks ago. She also does a pet battle content. Check her out. Simri Brightblade, she actually was turned into a pet tamer. And then Hazel from Hazelnutty Gaming, I got a chance to speak with both of them in beta. It's cool when you see other people you know or don't know and get to know them a little better in beta, so that was cool. And then just, you know, making sure I log in for Garrison missions. I still want to collect that gold. I haven't been playing a lot of like regular Legion beta, more beta than regular play, and I'm excited for the patch tomorrow. So yeah, that was my week in WoW.
Nice. I know Sauce actually did some things in WoW, so that's exciting.
I actually did. So I'm visiting my mom. So I'm out of town. I think my lovely lady's probably watching tonight. So to her. I know,
she's
right?
She's watching me, not you.
Yeah, it's fine. I live with her. but yeah, so we put together a moose run for, it was specifically for one person. However, there was a lot of people on Sunday, and we got probably about 6 to 7 people their moose.
Minus those that I think had already had it, right? That had already acquired it?
No, there was a lot of them that didn't. I think one person didn't have it, or already had it, excuse me. Mm. But yeah, so some people had to leave, but we'll get them back maybe this coming up Sunday, if I can kind of swindle that in there. I don't know, buy some flowers, maybe some chocolates, something like that.
Wine and diner, that's the way to a woman's heart, sir.
I know, right? We'll go get sushi. Maybe that'll make up for it. But yeah, so it was good. I did have to put the big boy pants on and be a fucking asshole for a little bit because, you know, you get all the riders together and they just forget about, you know, everything, what's going on, the reason why we're there and who it's for and stuff like that. So, yeah, I had to tell everyone to shut up and focus because I was not going to waste my time wiping for the next 2 hours. And Remedy showed up for the final pull and with another very high class DPSs, and we one-shot it on that last pull, so it was totally worth it. I'm happy that we were able to help a lot of people, and I talked to Remedies as well as I think Aja in regards to see who else needs it from Riders, and we'll try to get that, you know, within the next couple weeks.
Nice.
So
super. Yeah. Tight. That's awesome. Yes. I like to see guildies get stuff. It's nice.
If I can get my intro web sorted, I'll even make a guest appearance to come help out because you guys help me.
You're gonna help out the casuals.
Yeah. Go. I mean, I'm going to come down off my super mythic pedestal, just, you know, unlike Hots, and actually come amongst the people.
Nice.
And you're a little bit better than him, right? Actually helping out the rest of the guild.
Well,
he raids in Argent Crusade gear, though, so don't let him fool you. He's only got the best of the best.
That was me misdirecting you. You were like, oh, this guy's a joke. And then I come out swinging from the other side and, bam, mythic. No, but you guys helped me out ages ago trying to get it, and I figure I can repay that.
Was it Imperator? Why the fuck is Bloc dead? I don't know. After raid. So I have a confession.
The only way that could have got worse is if I still had the fucking jousting thing on.
It was so good. And I was like, I shrugged. I was like, I did raid with a fishbowl once. and my Stormwind cloak instead of my actual cloak.
Yeah, something special right there.
See, it happens to the best of us.
I've tanked with fishing poles before.
My week in WoW consisted of a lot of beta stuff and then guild prep, doing all the guild bank things, prepping, cleaning up the roster, doing what we need to do. We're revamping Hunger Games. Doing all the things that a guildmaster needs to do to prepare for all her people coming back to life. So that's what I've been doing. I did take a weekend off of non-Pwncast, non-guild stuff. It was awful.
Non-anything.
It was awful because today was just a mess of things. Just a pile of crap on top of a pile of crap on top of a
pile of crap. Just replace those people and enjoy your weekends, Belle.
But I did cut loose. I went to a drag show on Saturday, which was really fun. I went to a drag show. So in a previous life, before I just stayed in the house all the time gaming, I did frequent drag shows quite a bit just because I really, really like going
dressing
to drag
like
shows.
A man?
No, I don't dress like a man. I go there.
You wanted to support Dark too, right?
I did try to get my friend to be like, dude, we could totally be drags. And they're like, no, you have to be a boy dressed as a girl. And I'm like, yeah, but Connie and Carla, if you guys have ever seen that movie, they impersonated drag queens and did a great job. I just have to contour a little bit better, guys. I can do it. But I had a freaking blast. I had a lot of alcohol, which was great because I did not puke, which means my pre-gaming for BlizzCon is good. Right? We're good.
Training has begun.
Yeah, it's good. I didn't throw up and I didn't pee myself, so that was good. I did take a video of my friend peeing on the side of the Circle K and posted that to my Facebook. So if you're friends with me on Facebook, you got to see that lovely thing. You should
not. Nice bum, where are you from?
Don't pee in public with me having a phone, guys. Because if you pee in public.
Or just give your friends some privacy while they're trying to urinate.
There's no privacy in front of the Circle K on the side of the building.
There's no privacy in public, dude.
There was no privacy. If I didn't take a video, somebody else was going to for sure. But she had a nice rump, so that was okay. The Circle K, though, guys, I want to shout out to the Circle K guy. He did give her toilet paper. He told her she could not use the employee restroom, right? So then we're like, well, she has to go to the bathroom. What do you expect us to do? And he's like, I mean, I can't let her use it. It's against the rules. So then we were basically like, so can she pee outside? And he's like, well, I can't tell her she can, but I also can't physically stop her if she's peeing outside. So I was like, okay, then do you have toilet paper? So he...
You probably thought she was some sort of dope fiend or something.
He gave her... No, we were just drinking.
No Pokemon Go. You can talk about drag drinking. Queens, though.
I can't wait for this fucking Pokemon show Go? To be over.
I just thought I that was a little odd-ish.
All of these guys are going to get yelled at so hard when I hit this stop button for the stream. It's like not even... Like so much, I can't even
What did I
there.
Do?
But, yes, so that
Not
was
a thing.
That was basically my week in WoW. But other than that,
guys, sounds like a good one.
We're going to go ahead and get the hell on out of here because, to be quite honest, I'm pretty much done. I have nothing left in me, but I love everybody. Make sure you guys check out the PDQ. Make sure you follow us on Facebook. And as always, comment and tell us what you think. We're going to go ahead and get on out of here, guys. We will see you next week. Bye.
I don't have any figurines.
Definitely lost subscribers on that one.
Are you not going to talk in the post scene? Does he get all the words, Angie? We're done.
We're done. We're fired.
Looking for God. 4 more cast members. If you're interested, please email Mel at podcast.net.
I didn't say anything. I said nothing. I just said he had a sunburn, just like me.